Kreimschmidt by Fyodor Dostoevsky. Audiobook 24x38. He saw that Porfiry Petrovitch had not been embarrassed just before either, but that he, Raskolnikov, had perhaps fallen into a trap, that there must be something, some motive here unknown to him, that, perhaps, everything was in readiness and in another moment would break upon him. He went straight to the point at once, rose from his seat and took his cap. Porfiry Petrovitch, he began resolutely, though with considerable irritation, yesterday you expressed a desire that I should come to you for some inquiries. He laid special stress on the word inquiries. I have come, and if you have anything to ask me, ask it, and if not, allow me to withdraw. I have no time to spare. I have to be at the funeral of that man who was run over, of whom you know also, he added, feeling angry at once at having made this addition and more irritated at his anger. I am sick of it all, do you hear? And have long been. It's partly what made me ill. In short, he shouted, feeling that the phrase about his illness was still more out of place, in short, kindly examine me or let me go, at once. And if you must examine me, do so in the proper form. I will not allow you to do so otherwise, and so meanwhile, goodbye, as we have evidently nothing to keep us now. Good heavens! What do you mean? What shall I question you about? Cackled Porfiry Petrovitch with a change of tone, instantly leaving off laughing. Please don't disturb yourself, he began fidgeting from place to place and fussily making Raskolnikov sit down. There's no hurry, there's no hurry, it's all nonsense. Oh, no, I'm very glad you've come to see me at last. I look upon you simply as a visitor. And as for my confounded laughter, please excuse it, Rodion Romanovich. Rodion Romanovich? That is your name. It's my nerves, you tickled me so with your witty observation, I assure you, sometimes I shake with laughter like an india rubber ball for half an hour at a time. I'm often afraid of an attack of paralysis. Do sit down. Please do, or I shall think you are angry. Raskolnikov did not speak, he listened, watching him, still frowning angrily. He did sit down, but still held his cap. I must tell you one thing about myself, my dear Rodion Romanovich,